Hi, this is Sriyank Siddhartha and welcome to another video on Kotlin programming. So in this video, I will discuss something interesting which you can use in your project as a part of Kotlin coding convention. Now many a times we should prefer using a function over declaring a property in your class. And sometimes we prefer to declare a property over declaring a function, right? So in this video, I will discuss about when should you use a property and when should you use a function. So let's get started. So in Kotlin, you should prefer using properties over function if the following conditions are met. Now notice here that by property, I mean only the read-only properties, which are declared only using the val keyword. So if a piece of code in your algorithm requires no argument, if your code does not throw an exception, if your code is cheap in terms of resources, that is, it only does simple computation inside it, and if your code always returns the same result when executed, then in such a case, you should always use a read-only property over defining a function. So let me show you an example. Suppose we have a class box with three properties, width, height, and length. Well, these are declared using val keyword, which means once we define their values during object creation, their values will never change. They will be just read-only, right? Next, we have another property used space, which is initially zero, which means initially our box is empty. And notice that it is declared using var keyword, which means the value of this property can change in future. Fine. Now suppose I define a function to compute the volume of the box and return the volume. So as per the rule we have seen over here, our function does not have any arguments. Our function does not throw any exception. Our function is doing a very simple calculation. So it fits here as well. And our function always returns the same result whenever invoked, because this width, height, and length are declared over here using val keyword. So the volume of the box will never change in future after we define it. So this function meets all the given criteria, right? So as per the Kotlin coding convention, we should instead prefer to use a read-only property instead of this function. So here, instead of this function, we should create a read-only property like this. So this code and this code are doing almost the same thing. In fact, in terms of performance as well, there would be no change. Both the code will work with equal efficiency. And additionally, if you decompile your code and look at the bytecode of this getter function for this property over here, you will find that internally the name of this getter function will be exactly same as this getVolume function over here. Fine. So again, in terms of performance, there would be no change. Moving on, suppose we have another property such as availableSpace. Its getter returns a value which is volume of the box minus used space. Now the volume of the box is like a constant value because the width, height, and length which computes the volume are declared using val keyword, but the used space is a variable property. And since it is var, so its value can change any time in future. Now as per the rule, our code, which is this property declaration along with the getter, the first three rules are met by our property, but the last one is not met. That is, our property does not return the same result when called. So in this case, we can apply the rule in the reverse order. That is, if these conditions are met, then we should prefer using the read-only val properties over the function. But since the last criteria is not met for our given declared property, So in this case, we can apply the reverse rule and we should prefer using a function instead of this read-only property, right? So instead of having a separate property of available space, we should prefer using a function like this. And of course, this code and this code in terms of performance are exactly the same. It is just that if we follow a convention in any programming language, it just adds more consistency to our project. In fact, these rules are not created by me. It is as per the official guidelines published on official Kotlin Lang website, which you can find here. So yes, again, this was a very short video on Kotlin programming. So if you found this video informative, then give this video a thumbs up. And to support this video, please comment in the comment box below. If you are new, then please subscribe to my channel. This is Sriyank Siddhartha signing off, and thanks for watching and have a good day. Bye.